Hey, welcome back to the channel. Kyle here, and today we're going to take a look at these products right here, the Bratza Vario Plus and the Bratza Vario W Plus. These are updated models to the classic Bratza Vario, and so today I want to talk about what Bratza has updated in these grinders. Where do these grinders sit in the current market we have today? Could this be the best home grinder for you? And should this be a grinder you're considering depending on your situation? At the end of this video, we're going to brew some coffee and also compare it to one of my personal favorite home grinders, the Niche Zero. And I believe this is a great comparison. While it might not look like it on paper, you're gonna be interested by the results. So stick around for that at the end. Yeah, we're gonna get into it. Before we do, I wanna give you a disclaimer that Bratza did send me these grinders to test and review. They wouldn't be attending the Specialty Coffee Expo this year, so they were wondering if they could send these grinders my way to see if I enjoyed the experience I had. I agreed to do this and create a video for all of you on the basis that it would be a completely unbiased review and I can give my honest thoughts. They agreed to that, so there was no money exchange in this process and they do not get to see this video before you do. I thought it was important to give that disclaimer though, because Bratza did send me these grinders to test. So let's talk about the Bratza Vario Plus and the W Plus, talk about the upgrades and differences from the original Vario. And let's also give some context to the Vario for those who are unfamiliar with that popular older Bratza grinder. So the Bratza Vario was a 54mm ceramic flat burr grinder. It was pretty popular for people who love traditional espresso. Think more textured, old school style espresso, very different from modern espresso. For me, I've never really enjoyed that style of coffee. It's just a personal preference of mine. And so for me, I've always steered away from those ceramic burrs for both espresso and filter because I just... coffee was mediocre at best for me. But people started modding the Varios over recent years and adding the Forte, Bratza's more expensive grinders, BG stainless steel flat burrs to the Vario. With this, they've aligned the grinders and added mods to keep the retention as low as possible. Now in this video, I'm not gonna go in depth on the mods you can do for the Vario. That's not the purpose of this video in particular. Rather, if you wanna learn more about the original Vario and all that it can be with some modifications, I'm gonna link Lance Hedrick's video down in the description below. He's got like a 30-minute video on the Vario. Go check that out after this video is done. Now, one of the most popular mods to the Vario that they've introduced to the Vario Plus is the Forte's metal burr chamber. A lot of people didn't love the lack of rigidity in the burr chamber of the Vario, especially for its price point. So people have been taking the burr chamber and taking the metal burr chamber from the Forte and adapting it to the Vario. And the Plus and the W Plus out of the box have this installed. I think it's a huge plus. And a lot of people are gonna enjoy this change. It adds a little bit of rigidity, but it also helps with the alignment of these burrs and keeps them in place for a longer period of time, an issue that a lot of people with the Vario realized over years of use, that it would lose its alignment and it would have to be realigned often to get the best quality cup possible. Go watch Lance's video for more information on that. Now the Plus and the W Plus, like I said, comes with this out of the box, but more than this, Bratza has added a few more features like changing the plastic arms and knobs of the adjustment to metal versions. This feels completely different in my opinion. It just never felt like it was a premium experience. It definitely feels a lot better with the metal adjustments. It's not a perfect system. It kind of does feel outdated compared to some other grinders on the market today, but I do respect this adjustment system. It's very easy to communicate recipes. It just works really well. I guess if it's not broken, don't fix it. That's really all I have to say about that. They've also added a backlit screen for the Plus and W Plus, which is a nice feature. A lot of people like grinding coffee really early in the morning, and seeing a screen that's not backlit is, well, it's the worst. They've also added LED lights like the Virtuoso Plus so that you can see your grounds as they fall in the chamber. It's fine, it's cool. And obviously they've added the white color, which is new. It always used to be this color right here. It's still pretty beautiful, but it's nice to have options. But the most important upgrade, in my opinion, for the W Plus, and only the W Plus, is the burr set. They've added the 54mm stainless steel burr set from the Forte BG burrs. This is huge. For me, this is one of the biggest changes that Bratza could have made to this grinder. They only added it to the W Plus though, and we're gonna talk about that because that's confusing. Now, if you already have a Vario, this is not an upgrade worth considering. You can simply get those parts separately and install them into your current Vario. But if you're the kind of person who likes to buy something and out of the box, it has exactly what you want, this is a great upgrade. This is an awesome upgrade. And if you don't yet have a Vario, well, this might be the model you wanna consider. Possibly, maybe not. So let's talk about some pros and cons of these grinders, and then later on we'll brew some coffee, share my experiences with that, and then compare it to that special grinder. And the first pro with the Vario Plus and W Plus has got to be its range. I mean, it's hard to find a grinder that can do both espresso and filter coffee with a nice adjustment system to do so quickly. And this has that. Although quirky with the 1 to 10 and A to V, it does feel pretty good and I can't really complain. It was pretty easy to figure out really quickly. I do enjoy my experiences with dialing in coffees on this. It's not terrible. But yeah, being able to brew both espresso and filter is a huge plus in my opinion. And then you've got the Burr Set. And this is definitely an upgrade that we need to give as a pro. I mean, regardless of it not being on the Vario Plus, I think having it in one of the models is definitely a pro. And I'm excited that Baratza is watching what the community is doing and excited to open up the possibilities of having not only the metal grind chamber, but their Forte BG Burr installed in the Vario out of the box. Well done. To add to that, this burr set is created by a manufacturer called Ditting. And Ditting makes professional burr sets for many great grinders, including the X54. In fact, this burr set is the exact same burr set as the Melkoning X54's burr set. A grinder that's much more expensive. And the retention on this grinder is near zero. It's honestly amazing. The retention in my experience is anything from 0.2 to 0.3 grams and sometimes less. And it's pretty consistent throughout my testing. It's amazing. Like I was absolutely not expecting this. So let's talk about not cons, but things I wish that Baratza did differently or things that I'm just a little confused on. The first has got to be the price. Now, I understand that Baratza's got to make some money on these grinders, and these are their more premium grinders. But when I look at something like the Vario Plus at $529, this is in the similar price range of something like the DF64, a full metal grinder with stainless steel flat burrs and low retention. I wouldn't say that they're overpriced by any means. I think that the results, especially from the W Plus, are fantastic. If you're wanting to get into the Vario, you might want to look at getting an older Vario used and modding it to get the same features as this one. Baratza is probably not going to love me saying that, but it's a great option for a lot of people. And then we got to talk about what I'm most confused on. Why give the Plus the ceramic burrs? I do get a lot of people enjoy those ceramic burrs. I just don't think that's what most people want. And maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm completely wrong in this. I just feel if you look at the rest of the landscape of home grinders, the stainless steel burrs would have made this grinder incredibly competitive at $529. So I would love to see the Vario Plus have an option out of the box for stainless steel burrs at no extra cost. I think if you can make them the same price and the only difference between these two grinders is the scale built into this grinder, I think the Vario Plus could be one of the best home grinders in the market. And you might say, well, Kyle, that's not very fair. It makes more sense that they put the more premium burr set in the more premium grinder. And I wouldn't argue with you there. But the part that's got me very confused is that the W really can't be used for espresso very well. Let me explain. The Vario Plus comes with this metal port filter holder out of the box. You can remove the grind chamber and you can place this in its place. You can put your portafilter there, dial in how much time you want your coffee to grind, and it'll fall into the portafilter. Now, if you're single dosing, you won't use that timer feature, but you can simply hit plus, add more time than you probably need, and single dose your coffee pretty easily. But with the W, it gets really weird. You can't use that portafilter holder on the W because you can't override the scale. If I put this in here, the scale renders useless. And it just doesn't register what's on top of this portafilter holder. I don't think a lot of people are going to be using the W with a full hopper to grind filter coffee. Now, if there was an override button on the scale and you can just force your way through, I'd be okay with it. But if I go to grind coffee here and I tear this out, it'll only grind for about 5 to 10 seconds before realizing that there's no weight rendering on the scale and it will stop grinding. If I try to grind through, it just gives me an error message, which then I have to hit stop. I have to tear my scale again until I get an error message again. The Plus is great. The time feature's awesome. Just give me the burr set I want in that grinder. Something else I'd love to communicate is that the Vario is a great grinder out of the box. but it doesn't reach its full potential until modifications are done. I would have loved to see the grinders a little more aligned than they are out of the box at times. So I think as long as you know buying this grinder that out of the box it hasn't reached its full potential but has a huge potential, then I think you're fine. I mean, you can get the Vario Plus, have the metal grind chamber, and just get install those burrs separately, which you can buy from Baratza directly, and you're going to be around the same price as the W Plus, maybe a little bit cheaper, but then you have to do that. So maybe that's totally fine with you. And I'll probably be doing that in my Plus. I'll probably be adding metal burrs because I just really don't enjoy those ceramic burrs. So as long as you know buying these grinders or any Vario in particular, that out of the box, it's good but not great. And with a couple modifications, it can be fantastic, then you're fine. But just, you need to know that before buying this grinder because otherwise you might be disappointed. I'm getting tired talking about these grinders. I think it's time to brew some coffee. An espresso with the Vario and the Niche Zero. Now you can see one is a little fresher, so it has a little more crema, but let's test this out. They're both great, honestly. Now, obviously this wasn't a blind taste test, and some of you might criticize for that. I've been testing these and comparing the taste of these grinders for as long as I've had the Vario. This has been an ongoing test with not just one brew that has so many different variables in brewing a cup, but rather dozens of coffees comparing the taste profiles in these two cups. So here's what I would say. The Vario Plus is a ceramic burr grinder. I don't love the profile it creates, but the Vario W Plus has a wonderful stainless steel flat burr. And honestly, the results it creates is fantastic. That burr set does need a good amount of seasoning to be able to break it in. I had to get about 10 pounds of coffee in that grinder before I could really see some consistency shot to shot. Regardless, out of the box, the W Plus is a pretty good espresso grinder for a flat burr. Now the Niche Zero. I mean, I've talked about the Niche Zero so many times on this channel, but it just has a very different flavor profile. The Vario really excels with this BG burr set in high clarity and transparency. But the Niche Zero, creating more fines in its distribution, will lean towards a more complex style of espresso. And to be honest, I would take either one happily. And honestly, it's really hard to say which one makes better coffee. I think if I had done the Alicorn alignment on the W Plus, this grinder would be unreal and I'd probably take it over the Niche Zero. But out of the box, I think they're very, very close, understanding that there are very different flavor profiles for each one of these grinders. Now when it comes to build quality, the Vario uses plastics, unlike the Niche's full metal design, other than its plastic lid, and it uses wood pieces. The Vario doesn't feel cheap by any means. I think it needs to be said, there are still a lot of metals on here. The full front fascia, other than the front plate, is all metal, and most of the internals now are metal as well, so there's no complaints there. Though I will give the ups to the Niche Zero in this stance. So out of these two grinders, which one would I recommend to you? Do I think the Vario Plus and the W Plus is now a grinder that can compete with the heavy hitters like the Niche Zero, the soon-to-be Eureka Minio single dose, and other single dose and grinders like the DF64 and so on and so forth? Yeah, I do. I think this is a grinder that's now worth considering, especially out of the box. The Vario has been a grinder that's been worth considering for a while, as long as you were willing to put the work in. But for many, that just isn't a recommendation I'm willing to give, depending on their skill level and their comfortability with doing so. I can now comfortably recommend the Vario W Plus out of the box and recognize that the person receiving that grinder is going to have a great experience. And maybe that's you. The W Plus is a great grinder, understanding that it's not perfect out of the box, and with some break in time and seasoning those burrs, maybe some alignment, and maybe a modification down the road, the W Plus might be the best option for you. If you love that high clarity, high transparency in your cups of coffee, especially filter coffee, the W Plus is fantastic. Now, if I had to decide which one I would choose out of these two for filter coffee, it would be such an easy choice, and that would be the Baratza Vario W Plus. I wouldn't take the Vario Plus with the ceramic burrs, but if you upgraded those to the BG Forte burrs for $50 to $60, then absolutely. But the W Plus out of the box is unreal for filter coffee. The Niche Zero creates a great cup too, and to be said, the Niche Zero does need some seasoning as well, so when it comes to comparing these two, they're very similar in that regards, where the Niche has a lot of complexity, it's just a different grinder altogether. So what's my verdict here? Well, I think the Vario has come a long way. I think out of the box, it's now a grinder I'm willing to consider recommending to friends who don't want to mod their grinders. If you're in a spot where you don't want to spend this much money, but you want the results of the Vario. My recommendation would be finding a used Vario, finding one of the original Varios and modding it so that it has the same features as the W Plus. But if you're not, if you don't want to have to buy something and then have to mod it, then the W Plus from Baratza is a fantastic grinder. While it does have some quirks with not being able to use that portafilter holder without having some frustrations in its use, I think it's still a great option for many people. I think this is a grinder worth considering. At $5.99, it really does compare to grinders like the Niche Zero, the DF64, and some other single dosing grinders. Well, let me know down in the comments below. Do you like the Vario? Do you like the upgrades to the Vario Plus and the W Plus? Is this a grinder worth considering? Is this a grinder you're gonna be looking at? Let me know down in the comments. That'll be a place that I'll be hanging out. We'll see you guys all next time. Peace.